Glasgow for years has not been known for Asian shopping itself, so a lot of people would go to Birmingham, to Manchester, to London, and we thought to ourselves, let's bring it all to Glasgow. But we thought we wanted to do something different to stand out. A lot of the guests, when they do come in, one of the first questions we do ask, do you know what the bride's wearing? Because we don't want the bride to obviously be upstaged by anybody. I mean, I always have a joke that when you go to a wedding, you can see who the family members are because they're all probably wearing the same outfit. You can see the colour coordination itself. So everybody's kind of different in a sense, but it's led mainly by the bride and groom.
And for many guests, it's not just one outfit they have to think about.
You used to have the mehndi, the wedding day, and the walima, which would be the reception itself. Now people are kind of taking it a step further now, so you've got the bridal showers, we've got things called the dua, and then people have like kind of made more and more days. So as a guest, if you're told, right, you've got these 5 days, you need to get 5 outfits that don't cross over in terms of the theme. So you kind of need to buy 5 separate outfits with 5 different identities to turn up to these 5 different events. It's kind of colours that make you feel happy about yourself to kind of get look forward to the wedding itself. Because the wedding in Asian culture itself, it can be emotional for the females as well, because it's kind of obviously leaving one family to join a family. You can see the pinks and the golds and stuff, things like this. It's very loud and proud. The waistcoats itself, again, you can see the cut work, the detail work on this one itself, it's beautiful. It's one of the ones that I do like a lot. It's not everybody's taste. So the biggest challenge sometimes is trying to get the guys to actually physically try on the clothes itself.
What shoe size? 7.
Well, I think as a salesperson or the person in the man, I need to put my foot down sometimes. I like a person who knows what they want, but I also like the people that don't know what they want as well, because that's the challenge for me. And personally, when somebody comes in and me be able to kind of dress them up in a way and they feel comfortable about it, and knowing the fact that, you know what, I was right to trust Adnan, it's kind of a rewarding kind of thing, to be honest with you.